Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we will be showing you how you can turn your Raspberry Pi into a print server. There are numerous reasons why you may want to set up a print server. For example, you can convert an old USB-only printer into something that can be easily printed over Wi-Fi. Additionally, some older printers just refuse to work with modern versions of operating systems such as Windows 10 and 11. With cups and a Raspberry Pi, you can work around this issue, as your print jobs will be sent to your Raspberry Pi, which will then be issued to your printer. The Raspberry Pi makes a fantastic print server as it is relatively cheap to keep running 24/7. It also has more than enough performance to be able to handle sending print jobs to printers. You could even get away with using the weaker Raspberry Pi Zero series. Now, before you get started, you will want to ensure that your Raspberry Pi has a static IP address configured. The best way to achieve this is using DHCP reservation on your router. However, it is possible to do this through Raspberry Pi OS, and we have linked to a guide on this below. Once you're ready to go, open up the terminal on your Raspberry Pi or connect over SSH. The first thing we'll want to do is ensure the operating system is up to date. To do this, we must first update the package list by typing in sudo apt update and pressing enter. Once the package list is updated, your operating system will now be aware of any packages that need upgrading. We can upgrade these packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade-y. With the operating system now up to date, we can move on to installing the software that will turn our Raspberry Pi into a print server. The key piece of software that we'll be installing is called CUPS. CUPS is the go-to solution for dealing with printers on Linux-based operating systems. To install CUPS and some other critical pieces of software, type in sudo apt install cups printer-driver-guttenprint, and then hplip, and then finally samba. The guttenprint package provides us with numerous additional print drivers for popular brands such as Canon, Epson, Lexmark and Sony, as well as a few more. The hplip package we're installing adds additional drivers that helps CUPS talk with HP printers. Finally, we install Samba to help CUPS talk with Windows-based operating systems. If prompted, type Y and press Enter to continue with the installation process. Our next step is to add your current user to the LPAdmin group by typing in sudo usermod -a-g then LPAdmin followed by the dollar sign symbol, then user, all in uppercase. Adding your user to this group allows it to interact with the CUPS services. Our next step is to get the CUPS print server so that it will accept remote connections. To make this change, type in sudo cupsctl --remote-any and then press enter. To ensure that this change is actually read in by the CUPS server, type in sudo systemctl restart cups. The restart can take a couple of minutes to complete. Our next step is to access the CUPS web interface. This web interface is how you will manage your Raspberry Pi print server. With this web interface, you can control the job queue as well as add additional printers. To access this web interface, you will need to know the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. If you have forgotten it, you can get it by typing in hostname space hyphen capital I. In our example, you can see that our IP address is 192.168.0.32. Now, open up your favorite web browser and go to https://, followed by the IP address of your Raspberry Pi, which in our case would be 192.168.0.32, followed by the colon symbol, and then the port 631. Since CUPS generates a self-signed certificate, you will get a warning that your connection is not private. To proceed, you will need to click the Advanced button and then click the Proceed link at the bottom of the page. You will continue to see this warning as web browsers are unable to verify a self-signed certificate is valid. Now that you have access to the CUPS web interface, the first thing you'll want to do is add your first printer to your Raspberry Pi print server. To start this process, click the Administration tab, and then click the Add Printer button. You'll be prompted to enter a username and password to continue. With this, you'll want to enter the same username and password you used to log in to your Raspberry Pi. In our example, our username is Pi and our password is Raspberry. You will now see a list of printers that your Raspberry Pi has automatically detected. Look through this list and find the printer that you want to add and share for your CUPS print server. In our case, we will be selecting one of our Epson network printers. If you don't see your printer listed here, you'll want to make sure that it is plugged in and turned on. If you're connecting your printer to your Raspberry Pi using a USB connection, ensure there is no damage to the cable. Once you have your printer selected, click the Continue button. This next page will allow you to set a unique name for your printer as well as a description and location. The location option can be super useful, especially if multiple printers located around your office or home. Additionally, you'll want to tick the Share This Printer checkbox to allow other devices to connect and print from your printer. With this option disabled, only your Raspberry Pi would be able to send print jobs to this printer. Once you have everything configured, click the Continue button to add this printer. This next screen will display some additional information about your printer, including the make and the model that CUPS has guessed your printer is. If these are incorrect, use this screen to select the correct printer. These options are super important as each printer must be communicated with differently. If you find your printer isn't listed here, you'll have to look up whether a PPD file is available for it. These files are basically a way of telling CUPS how it should handle your printer. After you've ensured that you have selected the correct make and model, click the Add Printer button. You have now successfully added your first printer to your Raspberry Pi print server. You can now set some default options for your printer. The options available to you will differ depending on the printer you are using. In our case, we are only able to set the banners. As we don't want to set these, all we need to do is just click the Set Default Options button. These options can be configured at any time through the CUPS web interface. CUPS allows you to do quite a bit with your connected printers. For example, you can put it into maintenance mode so that no new print jobs can be sent to it. You can also manage any print jobs that are pending for that printer. With everything now configured, your Raspberry Pi print server is now up and running. Any device on your local network should now be able to automatically detect any connected printer. If you like this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.